In the 21st century, technology and data analysis play a major role in the world of cricket. On his 73rd birthday, we take a look back at the life and achievements of Mr. Bob Woolmer, a man widely regarded as the pioneer of technology, computer analysis and innovation in the cricket coaching circles. Woolmer is fondly remembered for his stint as coach of the South African team and his unfortunate demise under suspicious circumstances during the 2007 ICC Cricket World Cup, sending shockwave throughout the cricketing fraternity. A retrospective on a colourful life in the service of cricket is much overdue. Born in Kanpur, India in 1948 into a cricketing family, Woolmer made his debut for the county side Kent in England in 1969. By the time Woolmer made his test debut for England against Australia at Lord's in 1975, he was working as a school teacher in Kent as a physical education teacher, apart from running his own cricket school. An all-rounder with an ability to move the ball, he scored 3 centuries in Test cricket, all against Australia. He was named as one of Wisden's 5 cricketers of the year in 1976. His international career took a nosedive after he joined World Series cricket, a breakaway competition in Australia. An inability to hold on a regular place in the England team led to his controversial participation in the 1982 Rebuild Tour of South Africa. In defiance of a policy of boycott of apartheid in South Africa, ended his international career. Woolmer was the farthest thing from a sympathizer of apartheid. He joined Avondale Cricket Club in Cape Town, South Africa, a coloured cricket club in white supremacist apartheid South Africa. Years later, he would help South Africa in its move away from all-white cricket team to the one which featured all races of the Rainbow Nation. His stint as coach of Warwickshire saw great success and most importantly, a stint coaching the great Alan Donald. This combination was reunited when Woolmer was appointed the coach of South African cricket team in 1994. As a coach, Woolmer was innovative. He was one of the first to use computer analysis and brought techniques used by the goalkeepers in football to wicketkeepers in cricket. He is also credited for the popularity of the reverse sweep, a staple shot in today's cricket. Controversially, he tried to introduce the use of an earpiece through which a coach could give instructions to his captain on the field of play. However, the use of an earpiece was not allowed by ICC. At the helm of South Africa, Woolmer saw a combination of highs and lows. South Africa were a dominant side in both Test and ODI cricket. Ranked as number one ahead of the 99 World Cup, South Africa was widely expected to win the marquee tournament. However, an infamous mix-up between Alan Donald and Lance Klusener resulted in a tight semi-final and an elimination at the semi-final stage. The match-fixing scandal in 2000, which saw South African Hansie Kroonie admitting to match-fixing, hit Woolmer the hardest. While he had resigned from his role as coach a year earlier, Woolmer shared a close bond with Kroonie, even refusing to believe that Hansie Kroonie would succumb to match-fixing. He even called for the revocation of the life ban imposed on Hansie Kroonie. In 2004, Woolmer was named the coach of the Pakistan cricket team. It would be his last job, one filled with scandal and intrigue, not least what happened in the 2007 World Cup. By the time Pakistan arrived in the Caribbean for the 2007 World Cup, the team had been enmeshed in controversies, like the ball tampering row in 2006 at the Oval, resulting in a forfeited test match, followed by question marks over drugs usage and religious differences within the team. While Woolmer felt that some players were more interested in praying than playing, then-captain Inzamam Ulhaq reportedly was aghast at Woolmer's lack of faith. Things came to head following a loss against Ireland, which eliminated Pakistan from the World Cup, and then effigies of Woolmer were burnt in Pakistan. On March 18, 2007, Bob Woolmer was found dead in his hotel room in Jamaica. What was supposed to be a carnival of cricket now morphed into a tale of tragedy and suspicion. Alan Donald, who previously worked under Woolmer's guidance, called for the tournament to be suspended. While the show continued, the atmosphere was filled with intrigue. It was initially felt that Woolmer had died of natural causes. After all, he was known to be unwell, with the bus driver of the Pakistan team reporting that Woolmer was coughing all the way back to the hotel following the match against Ireland. He was known to be suffering from coughing fits, which would leave him gasping for breath and choking uncontrollably. Coupled with his history of diabetes and blood pressure, death from natural causes seemed most probable. However, following advice from a pathologist, Jamaican police announced that Woolmer's death was being treated as suspicious. What followed was a wide range of conspiracy theories featuring match fixing, mafia, Islamic extremism, and even an enraged Pakistan cricket fan. Interestingly, three members of the Pakistan squad, that is the captain Inzamam, assistant coach Mushtaq Ahmed, and manager Talat Ali, were interrogated by police over inconsistencies in their statements. This fueled more fire to the conspiracy theories. As time went on, doubts emerged over the theory that Woolmer was murdered. However, Woolmer's family have stated their confidence that the death occurred on account of natural causes. Bob Woolmer's life should be remembered as one in service of cricket. His work at the ICC set in place a system wherein an Ireland cricket team could beat a Pakistan team. His keen interest in technology has revolutionized the game, with data analysis and computer technology becoming a key feature of cricket coaching today. Thank you for watching our video. We hope you liked our video. And in fact, if you have not subscribed, kindly subscribe to our channel and help us grow. It'll mean a lot. Thank you once again.